to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I surrender all to you, everything I give to you, withholding.
First chapter, verse number 16, we're going to share with Thus Saith the Lord. I'm so happy I was in a portion of it in Sunday school this morning. Deacon Davis, amen, so skillfully going through the lesson about growing awareness. And his teaching was so profound that I had to share with Bishop Walker, but I tell you, it's something that we need to pay attention to in this day and this time that we're living in. Constantly be aware of all the falsehoods of things that are going on that make you think that it's normal. And so we want to say this morning, amen, God ring, amen, that in our lesson this morning, we're going to talk about some things. You know, math was one of my favorite strong subjects in school. Hello, somebody. That was one of the ones that I could do real well. I could count backwards, forwards, and sideways.
All right.
Somebody help me in that. I knew my brother was looking at me, backwards, forwards, and sideways. Yeah, I learned math in that backwards, forwards, and sideways. One of the things that somebody that's in school now can help me out. I had problems with, you know how you take a number and you have it to the power?
Algebra?
Say it.
Algebra?
Is that algebra?
Exponents.
Say it again.
Exponents.
5 to the 5th power, 6 to the 6th power. 6 to the 6th power.
5 to the 5th be 125.
Okay, how about 6 to the 6? Oh, can't be. Wait, let me tell you what happened. Y'all math wrong.
Uh-oh.
Oh, y'all been wrong, or Google drive wrong. One of two, somebody wrong. Look, Romans 1 and 16. Read, somebody read.
For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ.
For it is the power of God unto salvation.
For it is the what?
The power of God unto salvation.
For it is the what?
The power of God unto salvation.
Uh-huh.
To me. Everyone that believes.
Yes.
To the Jew first.
Yes.
And also to the Greek.
Uh-huh. That's good. Just want to stay right there. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, for just allowing us to recognize the power that you have given to the people of God. And Lord, those that believe, help them, oh God. Help them to hold on to the things that you have promised and shared with us, and we have believed. Help us not to let go of those things, oh God, that are true. Hold to the values, oh God, that are true, the values that you have declared in your word. And we won't let nothing disrupt us and take us from that. We give you name, the glory, the honor, and the praise. Our souls say, amen. Look at your name as a neighbor.
Neighbor.
Power.
Power.
To the sixth power.
To the sixth power.
Okay, I was writing this down as you walk, and I had problems saying power to the sixth power because I was trying to understand the sixth power. And some of you will probably we'll go through this lesson, and if I have an opportunity to come back and preach again, I'll give you another aspect of it. Amen. Because it's only, you know, it's so many things that we can look at in the scripture that don't denote power. And here, I want you to know that this particular scripture that Paul was writing to the Roman church, and Paul was telling them in so many words and uncertain terms, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It is the power of God unto salvation. And it's not just for me, but to everyone that believed. Okay, and dedicated to the Jew first and even also to the Greek. I read this particular text, and this particular text helped me to see that God had given us a power. And here, this particular power, it's actually by invitation only. Look at your name and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
It's by invitation only. You have to believe in order to get this power. Okay, it's not like you can go and you can buy this power. Somebody's going to grant it to you and bestow it on you. You got to believe God. Amen. And he said it's to the Jew first and then to everyone, to the Greek and to everyone else that believe. This particular power in this our text this morning, it talks about a power called dunamis. Dunamis. Somebody said dunamis. D-U-N-A-M-I-S. Dunamis. And this particular power, amen, I said it just denotes some things. I would go into the rest of them today, but time will not allow us to go through all of them. I've seen some powers in the scripture, amen, that we have to really unpack, because sometimes we don't realize the authority and the ability that we have as Christians. We don't realize it, and we don't really pay attention to it. But here in this particular text, the Greek, amen, word for power, amen, we see that in this particular word, dunamis, it talks about something that empowers us. It gives us the authority, gives us some explosive power. God has given us powers when you go through the scriptures that will take care and it will encompass and fill our spirit, it will fill our soul, and there's powers that will fill and deal with our body. And so, in doing so, we have to look at power as a whole. This morning, as we look at power, I think about, you know, many times our cars that we have. And it seemed like, you know, when you go to the gas station, this is only for those that got a guzzler. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Amen. If you have a real guzzler, you go to the gas station, and seems like the end of the week you're at the gas station again. Don't mean that you got a bad car. It means that it's just burning a lot of gas, burning a lot of fuel. So I help you quick. And when you have, amen, a car that runs, and I don't care how great the car is, amen, they tell me that the Tesla, amen, you don't even use the gas, amen, unless it's an emergency. They say the Tesla is an electric car, amen, it'll ride for a long time. But you know, all over the country now, they got electric stations.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And the reason not just gas pumps, but they got electric charging stations. Amen. And the reason they got charging station is, even though you charge that big extra battery that they have that run that car, and then sooner or later, the power is going to drain out of it. It's going to run down. Somebody help me in this place. Now, well, when your power run low, we have to look at what God has said to us. And I said to the sixth power, and Minister Allwood, as I said to the sixth power, I went back to my old math equations. I said 6 minus 6 equal. Oh my God, thank you, Jay. 6 minus 6 equals 0. Amen. And I said 6 times 1 equal. Uh-huh. And I'm looking at these numbers 6 and see how they increase. And I said 6 plus 6 equal. Mm-hmm. And then I said 6 times 6 equal.
36.
6 times 6 equal. 36. I don't know if that's 6 to the 6th power. Y'all help me? When I looked up 6 to the 6th power, I had to look it up. The reason I had to look it up is because I didn't know. And I came up with a number 46,656. I see y'all got to look it up too. Because folks don't recognize the powers that we have.
Wow.
I went through this text and I went through some things and I saw 6 different powers that God had given us. This morning, I wanted to talk about it. I did. I'm telling you. And when you start looking at these powers, one of them you may not get nothing out of. Next one, you might just get what you put in. And the next one, it may come up, it may be double. 66, 12. And then next one, it may be 36. Amen. And then the last one is giving you, you know, some powers. And, you know, when you say six to the sixth power, man, we got so much power. Somebody say power.
Power.
Well, the question came to me, well, he used this Greek word dunamis. And in the Bible, dunamis, they tell me that in the New Testament, dunamis is used, amen, not necessarily called dunamis, but it's used the word power, and it's used 120 times in the New Testament. And this power means strength. It means power. It means or ability. So God has given us the ability to do the things that he said in his word, that his word declared that we can do. Dunamis. Here we see that we that are living as Christians, amen, that in our own power and own strength we can't do with so much.
Amen.
But in God, amen, we have the ability to accomplish and to do the things that God has said that we can do. Amen. Amen. When the youth got up and they get up and they say the statement of praise, they say, I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. I have a right to every promise in the Bible.
Yes.
Well, I walk the path of righteousness that requires faith. For Hebrews 11:6 means that without faith it's impossible to please him. That means that they have the ability and the power. Somebody help me in this place. Amen. To do what God has said. Amen. God has given us the ability to obey and to do his word. You know, it's an indictment for me to look at this word of God and to preach and to teach and to tell you about God's power and all the miraculous things that his power and his word can do, and then you don't have the ability to do it. Somebody help me in this place. God is saying to us that we can accomplish those things that he said in our life that we can do. Sometimes when we look at the word dunamis, you gotta go back in the scriptures. You gotta pull it out. And so I went in the text, and I began to start looking at some of the scriptures and seeing how this word power relates in dunamis, and just one in Luke 1:35, it says, and the angel answered, amen, the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. And it says, so the Holy One, amen, to be born, will, amen, be called the Son of God. And you know, I can just imagine, you know, Mary, amen, being, amen, one of the ones that was looking for the Messiah to be born. She had a chaste life. Her life, she didn't change, amen. She didn't compromise. Somebody say compromise. She didn't compromise. Sometimes, amen, in life, we get to the place where we compromise. And we compromise, amen, based on, we just call it, our bishop got up and he didn't know what I was going to talk about, but he called it the norm. We compromised. In Sunday school, Dean John didn't know what I was talking about, but in Sunday school, we talked about how, amen, things will go on in society, and after a while, we just accept those things, amen. We, even if we deem it to be wrong, we accept it. It socially, it becomes acceptable in society, and when it becomes acceptable in society, we don't count it to be sin or be wrong, amen, because everybody is doing it. Let me tell you one thing, amen, that if I don't tell you nothing else, let me tell you this. Just because everybody is doing it don't make it right.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Just because they declare what they're doing is right still don't make it right. Just because preachers get up, oh God, help me in this place, wave a flag and they declare it is right, it don't mean that it's right. So we got to have a moral compass that we can talk to the world with, and we can tell the world this is what God has said. Now, most Christians haven't learned how to use the power. So when you got power, you use it recklessly. You hurt somebody. You damage somebody. Amen. You can't help somebody. Amen. You're trying to help somebody to get out of the mud and the mess that they're in, and you sitting up there telling them that they're dirty. Come on, that is not going to help me get up. How can I stop doing these things that's got a grip and got a hold of me? Then you gotta Yeah.
Amen.
And when Paul went to Rome, he was one of the ones that persecuted the church that was in Rome. Come on, somebody help me.
Some of those batteries get corrosion coming out.
church and come to church and go home and just, you just, all I saw, you know, I come to church and I you know, we had a good day, I waved my hand. Listen, waving your hand is not saying, hey God, here I am. Come on, somebody help. You got to learn how to bless him. You got to learn how to praise him. If somebody say, well, you know, church is something, you know, I want to hear the word. I don't want to have to shout. I don't want to have to raise my hand. I don't want to have to lift him up. Let's go back to the scripture. David went to God's house. And David, after he had all the mess that he had going on to in his life, David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Hey, our feet shall stand within thy gate. David began to give God all kind of praise. Hey, now, if you want to look at a messed up folk, messed up person, David was a messed up person. But the scriptures denote him as a man after God's own heart. Now, how can you be messed up and be a man after God's own heart all at the same time? Well, he would run to God. And every time you get in a situation in your life, you ought to run to God. We don't need to just run to God because we're in trouble. Somebody help me here. We ought to stay in his presence. We ought to live in his presence. We ought to walk with God in our life. Everything I do, every move I make, I got God in my heart, God on my mind. But I stay in prayer. So when I get in trouble, I don't have to worry about these confusing voices that's trying to speak into my life and tell me do this because thus saith the Lord. I know what the Lord said. The Bible said, and my sheep, they know my voice. And a stranger, they will not follow. If you don't know God's voice, you don't know what he has said in his word, you subject to a place where you can be straight away and pulled away. What's happening in this last days? People are being pulled away from the word of God. And you can ask yourself, well, if the Bible tell me after the Holy Ghost come upon me, I got power, how can people be drawn away from God? How can they start doing and doing things? Well, I can tell you how. It's just like you buy a brand new battery. That brand new battery got power. But most of us, we put them in places that they shouldn't be near or in. It took a minute for me to understand. It took a minute. Because if you put a battery near something, especially say hypothetically, you put it next to some screwdrivers and stuff, well, that metal on that screwdriver will draw that power from that battery. That's why we get corrosion and all these other things that come up out of it. Or you put it in a cabinet and you leave it there. Well, I can tell you right now, it's almost like seed. If you don't take a seed and you got it up in a bag, that seed got the potential to grow into whatever is inside, whatever it is set to grow into. So if it's a corn seed will grow into a corn. Listen, I have never seen somebody plant a corn seed, and when the corn seed grows, or when it grows, and when it grows, the seed grows, I've never seen just the seed come up.
Right.
Hello, somebody. Okay. Usually it comes up on ear. That's the ear, stop. Come up on the stop. And on the stop is usually an ear corn there. And if you shuck that corn, shuck that thing, get that skin off of it, you will find you got more seeds in there. More seeds on that. Oh, more kernel. You want to use kernel? Okay. You got more kernel. I don't know, seeds. More kernel. Yeah. They help me preach. I don't mind. Hey, go ahead. You got more kernel. Y'all helped me at the beginning with that math question. Y'all Googled it. I guess y'all still Googled it, aren't you? Huh? Somebody help me. Got more kernel. You know, they still Google them. They Google them. six power equal, no, it's 30, it ain't no 36, it can't be, because I know six out of six is 36. I already knew that, but I had to prove it, so that's why people still go. But listen here, so you're going to see that to the sixth power, amen, it multiplies more than what you expect.
Yeah.
And this is the year of great expectation. We are expecting God to do something. You can't expect God to do something you don't do nothing. You got to do something. Come on, you want God to move in your life, but you don't give him nothing.
I don't need it no more. I don't do that no more. can't even hang around you. Why? Because I can't even stand the smell of stuff no more.
Amen.
Well, you gotta make a decision. You have to make that decision. Listen, being sanctified don't come overnight.
Amen.
And God is not gonna sanctify you. I'm gonna bring it in. Listen, God is not gonna sanctify you.
Amen.
He's not. Yeah, He'll save you, but He won't sanctify you. You gotta sanctify yourself.
Amen.
And somebody say, well, how can I sanctify myself? Well, you got the power. Remember, I told you, you got the power.
Amen.
You already got the power. You got the power to do it. Amen. But you have to do it. Well, this is what Paul told them in the scripture. He told them, look, be transformed by the
renewing of your mind.
Huh? So you gotta change your mind. Thank you. You got to change the way you're thinking. And the enemy knows that if he can get in your mind, he's going to cause you, amen, to go in the wrong direction.
Yeah, thank you, Lord.
You don't believe me? Watch your kids when you go to the store.
Mm.
How do you know what tricks are? How do you know what those different kinds of cereal? Some of them, the name we can't even pronounce. And so when they go, they want those things. How many know about Power Rangers? How about Paw Patrol? I'm a shucker doo-doo.
What?
Shucker. Baby shucker. So it gets in their spirit. They know those kind of things. Right? And so we got to put in their spirit about God's power, not just getting saved. Listen, it's one thing about being saved. You know, you convince somebody to get saved. After you get saved, then what? Well, they got to walk right. I got the power to walk right, but you just don't know how. So you got to get in His Word, and you got to sanctify yourself through His Word. You got to cleanse yourself through the washing of the Word. It's the Word that's going to cleanse us. It's the Word that's going to sanctify us. It's getting in His Word and making us say, no. What does God say? I told them Thursday night, Bishop, I told them this is Bible class. I told them, I said, this is the way that you can start on being sanctified. Go in the Bible, the first thing you ought to study, get a good Bible, not one small, get a good Bible, and study everything that God said don't do. I know that's backwards. That's backwards, but, you know, because everybody wants you to do the things that God said do. Well, if you study everything that God said don't do, and when you say God said don't do it, you can verify it in the reference in Revelation, you find out if you go to hell for it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, people don't want to talk about going to hell. I was at a funeral yesterday, and nobody want to talk about going to hell. Everybody want to talk about going to hell. But I can tell you this, everybody ain't going up there.
That's right.
Huh? So you find out everything that God said don't do, and you put them over here and say, okay, God, these things I cannot do because God said don't do it. And then you find out all the things that He said you can do. Mm-hmm. And you're going to see that there's more things you can do than it is what you can't do. And what happens is, we get to the place where we watch all this stuff and see all these stars and all this stuff going on, and we feel that we got to have, you don't have to have everything that everybody else has. I never had a BMW, I had an old one. I'm trying to think of a car I never had. I never had a Cadillac. Never had a Cadillac in my life. I never had no Rolls Royce or Bentley. You're right. But it don't mean I can't get one.
Right.
See, you got to understand that you got to find out how God wants you to work, how He wants you to walk, how He wants you to talk, how He wants you to lead. Okay? And when you find out, you say, okay, I can't, I'm not going to do these things. These things, these things are off my radar. They can't exist in my life. And then you got to learn how to just follow those things. You don't like that, do that. You don't like that, do that. There's enough things that you can do, okay? You don't like being, you don't like and digging ditches, okay? Put something in your mind. Somebody help me here. Go to school. Listen. What I found out is that when young men come to me and say, man, you know, I got beef. I got a fella on the beef. You know the first thing I tell them is to get a trade.
Amen.
And the reason I tell them to get a trade is because some kind of way, amen, you got to be able to feed your family. Get a trade. Somebody said, I don't know. That's how it works. Listen. Our consequences, you know, we deal with it. So if we bring on ourselves, okay, you don't need to be pointing at the white man, the red man, the blue man. We bring stuff on ourselves. Come on, try it over this place. So when you get a trade, you can do some things.
Yeah.
You don't believe me. Listen, get with a plumber and be an apprentice.
Right.
And then you get in with that plumber and you are an apprentice, right? And you see that plumber every day you go on there and the people's drains are stopped up and they run that K-50 down the drain. And at the end of the day, them people write the plumber a check for $175.
Amen.
Do you not know that you can get your business card by, listen. Somebody say, well, I don't have no money to buy no K-50. You don't need no money. All you gotta do is rent it when you need it. Now I gotta spend $25, $50, $35, $40, help me, man. $40, $50 to rent a K-50. But Sister Pam is calling me because she know I do plumbing work. And Sister Pam will write me a check for $150 that sink stopped up.
Amen.
I made $100. All I did is maybe 20 minutes worth of work. Unstop the drain. Somebody said, well, oh man, that's hard work. Well, get a paintbrush. Practice somewhere else. Learn how to stay on the line. Stay on the line. Learn how to trim. Amen. The edges right. Nobody wants you to paint that house with paint all over the floor and all over the place. Learn how to practice those things. Man, get a trade. Somebody say trade. See, we got power, but we'll make society will make you think you can't do nothing. But Bible tells me, say, when you find out the things you can do, Paul, you find out in the scripture, say, I can do all things.
Yes.
Through Christ, that strength in me. He gave me power to do these things. Amen. Yes. Somebody's in this place.
Amen.
I gotta come back. Pastor ever let me preach again, I'll come back. Minister. Power. Amen. To the sixth power. To the sixth power. Somebody's in here.
Withholding nothing. Withholding.